Welcome all, it's Russ, and in this video we're going to talk about exceptions, which is how Python reports errors. Now, later on in the class, we will talk about how you can catch exceptions and so you can survive them. But for now, you can think of exceptions always as things that will kill your programs, cause them to fail. So to take a look at this, let's do a real simple error, and we'll use the example that we used in the type conversion video. If you don't remember my description of why this is not possible, why you can't do plus equals integer one on a string variable, then go back and review that video first and then come back here. Let's see what happens. When we execute this code, what we're going to get is what's called a stack trace. And so it says, hey, an error has occurred. Now it says the most recent call is last. We haven't used any functions yet, so we're only going to see one element in the stack. In a real program, we will see some functions here. But let's break down what all the pieces are. First of all, each of these elements in the stack trace will tell you what file it happened in. It'll tell you what line number it was on. And if it's inside a function, it'll tell you what function you're in. It will also print out the line of code. Now, of course, you could look that up. You could go to line two and say x plus equals one, it's already there. However, the stack trace gives it to you. It's very handy because it makes your debug quicker. Sometimes you'll be able to look at that stack trace and immediately say, oh, of course, stupid me, I should have fixed that. That's an easy fix. So all that information is there for you. You can always go back to the source code if it's not immediately obvious what's going on. The last thing it's going to print out is a description of what the error was. So in this case, it was a type error. And it says it must be a string, not an integer. So because you're trying to do plus equals on a string, it says the only thing that you could plus equals to me is another string. What does that do? I'll tell you about that later when we talk about concatenation. But for now, what we can just simply say is this is not a workable operation. So this is telling you what failed, and then up above are this stack trace that's telling you where the failure occurred and how it came about. All right, this is a lot more interesting if it's inside a function. So let's create a function, and let's make x be a parameter now. Then we'll do it like this, and then we'll say return x plus one. All right. Well, this is a perfectly reasonable function. If I pass it an integer, it will return one more than that. Not a big deal. But what happens if I pass it 1, 2, 3? Well, now, x will be a string, and when we try to do x plus 1, we will get our type error. All right, this is exactly what we saw. What does it look like here? Well, now we have two entries in the stack trace. Says most recent call last, so the deepest call is listed last. What is this telling us? It says says that in example.py on line four, we ran this line of code. There it is right there, same line of code. We called the function foo. Inside the function foo, there we are, we're inside the function foo on line number two of the exact same source file. We did this, return x plus one, return x plus one. So this is telling you not only where the error occurred, but also why we got there. And then it gives us the same error that we've seen before. If you have more layers, so here we're gonna have a function bar, which just takes a parameter and passes it on to foo. Then we'll have a function baz, which takes a parameter and passes it on to bar. And then we'll call baz. We'll get the exact same error, but now our stack trace will be longer. Because what we see here is that at the very beginning on line 10, we had baz, we called baz. And then when we were inside of baz on line 8, we called bar. Then when we were inside of bar on line 5, we called foo. And when we were inside of foo on line 2, we did something which caused an exception. So when you're debugging, it is your responsibility to track through these stack traces. Don't come to me or come to your TA and say, my program broke. We're happy to help you, but it's your job to do the first part of the work, which is to say, okay, my program broke. Here's the exception that was actually reported. Why did it crash? Okay, well, there was a type error, there was a name error, whatever. And then you go back through your history and you say, what were the chain of events that caused us to end up in that situation where the exception could occur? Try to describe that as best you can. Very often what you'll find is if you go back through the history and you think about what each function is doing, you're gonna find some place where you think, that's not really a good idea. Of course, the root cause of all of this is that we know that we're gonna be adding one to something, but what we stuffed into it was a string. So this line 10 is broken. We need to do something to it. All right, what are the other errors that you're gonna see? There's a whole variety of errors that exist inside Python, but let's talk about the ones that are most common in this class. X equals Y. What's wrong with this? Well, Y hasn't been declared yet. So we get a name error. Name Y is not defined. What about if X was an array and we could say Y equals X, X zero. That would work just fine. Element zero of the array would be this value 10. We could go to element one, which would be 20. Element two, which would be 30. No problem. All right, what if we go to element three? The valid indices in this array are 0, 1, and 2. So if we try to access element 3, list index out of range. What if X was a dictionary? One maps to A, negative 1 maps to B, Y equals X of 2. We'll get a key error. Key error means that you were trying to index into a dictionary, but the key does not exist within the dictionary. Two is not a valid key. What are some other things you get? Those are the most common. As we explore the language and we get deeper, we'll run into some other types of errors. So, exceptions. Exceptions are Python telling you you did something wrong. In an exception, Python will tell you where it happened, as well as the whole chain of function calls that got you there. And you need to trace back through your history to figure out what the root cause of your error was. Hope this was useful. Hope you learned a lot from this video. Bye-bye.